The government has announced its plans for a major rewrite of employment laws affecting tens of thousands of New Zealanders. National wants to extend the 90-day trial period under which new workers can be sacked. The unions have described the move as an attack on workers' rights, but business leaders say it will have a positive effect on employment, especially for those who struggle to find a job. Well, we have all sides of the argument this morning. Joining us today in Auckland, Labour Party leader Phil Gough, business leader June McCabe, and Unite Union Secretary Matt McCartan. And joining us from Wellington is the Chief Executive of Business New Zealand, Phil O'Reilly. Tēnā koutou and welcome to the program.
Kia ora, Shane.
Phil O'Reilly, let's begin with you. You say the changes will have a positive effect on employment. Tell us why.
What's been happening since the 90-day process was introduced for small business has been that businesses have been telling us that they felt as though the whole process of employment was de-risked. And that's of particular importance to young Maori and Pacifica people who struggle to find jobs. So what was happening in the past was that employers were feeling it was too hard to take on staff because of the perceived risks of a personal grievance claim. Well, if we can remove that, we get more people a chance to get into that first job, potentially send that second job, to give them an opportunity to demonstrate their worth, and then we can go on. Now, that looks as though it's a fantastic opportunity, particularly for those who are marginalised, those who are at the edges of the workforce, and an extension of it appears to be entirely appropriate, given all the reports that we're hearing from business that they like it and that it's had the impact that was intended.
Matt McCartan, are you receiving those same reports in terms of the current law? So if it is working, why not extend it?
Well, it was interesting is when you had the intro, you mentioned it would affect tens of thousands of New Zealanders. Actually, this will affect hundreds of thousands of New Zealanders. If Phil is saying that this is going to make a difference in terms of the marginalised workers, why has it been actually extended to every worker and every employer in the country? This will affect 400,000 New Zealanders every year who move from job to job. What this does is about control. This is about, I'm the feudal lord, you have no rights, I can sack you for whatever I want. What about the risk of a person who's offered a job, who's already in a job, moves to a job, what about their risk? You can get rid of someone in 90 days now in any time, providing you do it fairly. You actually say, look, I'm unhappy and this is what you're not doing and here's the training support, and get it right. If they still don't perform, you can actually get rid of them. What Phil is defending is cowboys who shouldn't be employing staff in the first place, because what they actually do, they want the right to sack someone without having to give them a reason. And that's actually why. This is ideological. I mean, Phil Gough, I'm sure, will mention this. This is political. This wasn't announced. This has been announced, you know, today at the conference by the new leader of the National Party, because it's a political campaign. This is a red meat attack on the working people. New Zealand workers, many of them, voted for Key and still support him because they think he's different. Well, this shows it's back to the same old class position as Tories will screw workers once they get into power.
June
and it's
McCabe,
a turning point in this government.
Is this about screwing workers and their rights?
I don't think so. I think the key point is about how you stimulate business activity. And when businesses...
Where's the evidence?
When businesses have to contemplate a process which is quite onerous on them personally around employment, and particularly if they have to change their structure to accommodate their cost constraints or whatever, they face quite a lengthy process to exit out of those arrangements. This allows that business to consolidate its position, give it some time so that it can get the productivity that it wants to achieve. And that's the key. We've got to get productivity, lift performance. Quite frankly, we need to start backing ourselves.
Phil Gough, you don't like these changes, do you?
No, and let me disagree with my friend June and Phil. De-risked, Phil? It de-risks the employer. It puts all the risk on the employee. You can now, under this piece of legislation, be sacked without a legitimate reason. That's what the legislation means. Right now you can be sacked legitimately, and people are every day. This gives the right to the employer across the whole of the workforce in the first 90 days to sack somebody without cause. June, it's not hard to sack people in New Zealand. The World Bank did a survey of New Zealand, found that we had the fourth most flexible labour laws in the country. But look, here's the essence of the problem. Everybody Their job is their most, one of the most important things in their life. It's their livelihood. No New Zealander deserves to be sacked without a reason being given or without a good cause. That removes the right of the ordinary worker to natural justice. It's wrong. It provides for the bad employer the right to illegitimately sack somebody for no good reason.
Phil O'Reilly, where is the natural justice with these proposed changes?
Well, let me just agree loudly with Phil Goff that jobs are critically important. And one of the tragedies that we have is that so many young Maori and Pacifica people are cut out of the workforce, and it's because they often lack literacy and numeracy, they might lack a stable family life, and they might have other issues going on. What are we doing as a country to make sure that we focus on them? Because if they fail, frankly, New Zealand fails. So what I'm about is trying to do everything we can as business people to make sure that they have an opportunity. And one of the things that happens right now is that they'll often get excluded from work because they're at the margins. They're not necessarily having the same skills or literacy and numeracy as other candidates. And what we want to do is de-risk the process of employment so that employers can say to them, particularly them, but not just them, I'll give you a chance. And if we can do that, we might get more of them into a job. And I'd agree then with Phil that then they can become a better contributor to society, and then they can have better family lives, and that'll be a good thing for all of us.
Look, Australia last month, Phil, created 45,000 jobs, 45,000 new jobs. They did it without this sort of draconian legislation. They've got far more protective laws in favour of their workforce than we have here. This is not the answer to finding jobs for people who are out of work. For the first 9 years of the 21st century, we had unemployment down to 18,000 people. Now it's 68,000 on the unemployment benefit. That wasn't because it's too hard to dismiss somebody who is coming on in their first 90 days of their work. There are other reasons behind that. What this law does is allow, and I heard you say it on radio, there are bad employers out there, just like there are bad employees. Not the majority, but enough of them. This puts at risk all of those vulnerable workers. The first 90 days of their employment, the boss can say, I want you out of here, not give a reason, never have to justify that decision, never face the chance that the worker can seek redress for unfair treatment. That's wrong.
And you know yourself,
I'll come back to Phil O'Reilly.
And others have these laws.